I'm so dedicated to my destination. I'ma get it how I live it with no hesitation. See me making moves and all this training proves that I'm possible.
When it comes to our eyes when we train, one of the fakest things that we do in the basketball community is we use our eyes all the time as if they're always gonna be unobstructed. For instance, if I was training by myself and I'm simply driving to the basket, my eyes are just simply free to see the basket for as long as I want. That's not gonna be very realistic to the game. Not only is the game gonna have obstacles in my way, such as taller defenders and action, but it's also gonna require me seeing details inside the defense, which means I'm not gonna be seeing this basket the entire drive of any drive typically. And so if we're overusing our eyes in that way, we're actually making training too easy and it's not gonna represent the game. So what we're gonna be looking at is blind finishing. I'm gonna go ahead and start driving with my eyes closed and I'm not gonna open my eyes until I'm just jumping. And now what you've done is you've given yourself the ability to truly react to your newfound space, newfound angles, and make adjustments in the air. Now that's what I like to do to a player's eyes, because I might jump and I'm not really seeing exactly my angles until I've cleared a little bit of space, and now I gotta be able to still make my adjustments. Which is why so often players can't finish from the air, because they're so used to just simply seeing their target early and being able to finish. We can't always rely on finishing from the floor. Sometimes we gotta finish from the air after we've already jumped.